Diarmaid O'Sullivan, you're very welcome to the studio. The week of a Munster final now coming up, do you miss it being involved?
Yeah, it is. I suppose, you know, when you leave inter-county hurling, it's a hard thing to take for a time, but, you know, I had the pleasure of dropping in, just having a sneak preview with the boys training during the week, and, you know, it set the pulses racing a small bit. Yeah. You know, it would be nice if you were heading to Thurles on Sunday.
Well, we'll get your view on that later with Paul Flynn here. It'll be interesting, yeah. But first, it's time for the eagerly...
It's going to be Michael Wadding from Waterford who'll be in charge this afternoon. Kilkenny won the toss. They'll play from right to left in the first half. Switches and changes been made already. And Aidan Hart gone to the corner. Damien Hayes got in towards full forward. As the referee gets the match underway. And Galway look for an early start here now with Angus Callanan trying to launch the opening attack. Balanced here towards Aidan Hart, and Hart puts that one between the posts and over the bar. Very good start in the opening attack. 15 seconds, goal on the clock.
That was a very important score, Ger, because it was a narrow enough angle, and sometimes you just see players taking shots from there, hitting them wide, but that was a very good start for Galway, and a great start for himself.
Oh, straight in front of goal, Aidan Hart was coming onto it, and the ball has gone wide. Final touch by Damien Hayes. Well, there were a number of Galway players there. Kilkenny's defence seemed to freeze momentarily. Not sure what to expect there. Goalkeeper was in trouble. Aidan Hart had a go. And there too as well was Damien Hayes.
Well, you see Tommy Walsh back in the line there just to cover things off. But that would have been a huge psychological blow to Kilkenny when they had made a mistake, if Galway could have capitalised.
As has been mentioned, of course, it's... something that Galway had to seriously think about, getting goals and getting them early on in this match. Owen Larkin instead for Kilkenny, hooked well by Adrian Cullinan, comes back here towards Henry Shefflin. Shefflin carrying it forward here as far as TJ Reid, getting sufficient latitude to have a go and put it over the bar. Best point of the match so far, TJ Reid. And it's 3 points to one. Kilkenny backed by the breeze here in Croke Park for the opening 35 minutes, and that was a very smart delivery by TJ Reid.
And that's the problem for Galway, Ger. You know, three or four players went on to two or three Kilkenny players, and Reid was the supporting man, free, and stuck it over the bar.
Again, JJ Delaney stays back. Oh, dangerously in for Shefflin, corner of the net. Henry Shefflin gets the first goal of the match in the 13th minute. He drifted into space beautifully. Just watch it again. In, over the corner back. Beautiful delivery from Henry Shefflin, way in past Colm Callanan. It's a lovely goal. Kilkenny go for more scores. Beautifully into the hand of Owen Larkin. They're winning those puck outs and winning them well. Into Rice, and Rice lets fly. Two shots at the target. And a second point for the 26-year-old from Carrickshock. Well, having won the puck out, they'd only one thing on their minds, and that was to set up a scoring chance. Owen Larkin, hurler of the year just over 12 months ago. Damien Hayes is in after it. Noel Hickey is there trying to guard it, and they make a mess of it, and in comes Damien Hayes, and Hayes prods it into the back of the net. In the 19th minute, so 6 minutes after Kilkenny's goal, this is one that the Kilkenny backs should have dealt with. Between Noel Hickey and PJ Ryan, they made an absolute calamitous mess of this, and Damien Hayes got in, past the goalkeeper, over the line, and it's 1-5 to 1-2. Kilkenny are contemplating a change. We might see John Tennyson come in a couple of moments. He's being prepared, because I think Brian Cody and the selectors are a bit concerned. Tennyson required. In comes Shefflin. Had the obvious pass to give, but he goes for the shot himself. Oh, it lands on the netting and over the bar. Good one by Henry Shefflin, who's now got a goal and 3 points. Up towards Aidan Hart, playing in the corner. His man is Jackie Tyrrell. And the Kilkenny man tries to get it on his stick. Tannion gets in there as well to try and help out the number 15 for Galway. On the ground. Nobody able to get it. Eventually it's John Dalton gets it forward. Cleared by Michael Rice. Midfielder had to go back to help out. Picked up here by Richie Power, swinging it, having a go and putting it over the bar. Ending all that uncertainty at the other end of the field. Very decisively put between the posts by Richie Power. One of the top young stars in senior hurling. Damien Hayes trying to take it forward. It's prodded on by Irla Tanyan. Back went Tommy Welch. Given the protection from Noel Hickey to clear it downfield. David Collins once again. 45 metres out from his own goal. Neatly over here to Angus Caldon. Hasn't really got motoring yet in this match. This is a good looking shot. Stopped by the goalkeeper. Could have gone anywhere. As Irla Tanyan was breezing in once again here. Dangerous moment for Kilkenny once more from Angus Callanan's shot, which PJ Ryan, with the aid of the post I think as well, managed to take it down here, and there was nothing Irla Tanyan could do about it to steer it back on target. Tony O'Gregan hand passing it away into the clear into Andy Smith, well blocked down by TJ Reid. Back towards Henry Shefflin, always available, but this time it drifts away to the right-hand side and it's missed. 10 wides now for Kilkenny as well. Caldon's puck out is a poor one, straight to TJ Reid, and he hits it back with interest and puts it over the bar. Another for TJ Reid, that's two in this final. The young captain from Ballyhale Shamrocks benefiting by that poor puck out by Colm Caldon.
Well, always dangerous to hit the ball straight out the middle and low, and David Collins was free on the wing and he wasn't spotted.
This is good play again by John Tennyson. They're glad to have him back. The competition for places will be intense as Henry Shefflin has another shot from way out the field, from right in the middle of the park, and it's one goal and six now for Henry Shefflin. Two in a row for Kilkenny, and they open up an ominous gap from Galway's point of view. The margin is 6 points. 31,376 people at Croke Park this afternoon. And Richie Hogan now is tormenting Galway and tormenting Shane Cavan in particular, performing his party piece like the egg and spoon race. And that's over the bar. What an intro. First point of the day for Richie Hogan. His sixth ever championship point. Brilliant play here by the 22-year-old. Absolutely tormenting Shane Kavanagh. The puck out as far as TJ Reid. Broken down here by Richie Hogan, chasing after it. Across comes a very lively Aidan Fogarty, setting up Richie Power. What wonderful team play. Three of the forwards combining, the entire full forward line, to get Richie Power his second point. That's wonderful, brilliant team play by Kilkenny. Tony O'Gregan comes across. Joe Canning, nice little flick, lovely bit of skill here. Holding on to it. Owen Lynch, and that one has gone over the bar. Very good point by Owen Lynch. A lovely little flick back in by Joe Canning to make it possible for him. He may not have scored, but he's set up this scoring opportunity for a colleague. Look at that lovely little flick there, keeping it away from JJ Delaney. John Mulhall hoping to open up a championship account here with a score in this game. Richie Hogan has done that already in this match. He's got one. Here he is, darting in. Giving back the obvious pass here to Owen Larkin. Thought about sending the pass back. Hit it over the bar instead. Nice dummy by Larkin. And that is his first point of the match also. But he's been fully involved. There was a little dummy intending to play it back out to Richie Hogan. Deceived the backs. Got it onto the right. Placed it over the bar. Eight between them. Breaks down here. Everybody's scrambling in after it. Joe Gantley, number 21. But it's John Dalton who emerges with it. 119 to 111. Can he get another one? And he can. Brilliantly done. He did it as a 15-year-old against Kilkenny playing minor. He's done it here. And the referee set to blow the final whistle. Kilkenny are the Leinster hurling champions once again in the first ever final against Galway here in Croke Park. They have seen off the challenge of the tribesmen.
and a comprehensive victory by Kilkenny. John McIntyre will have no complaints. Brian Cody will relish the victory. And at Croke Park, it's finished Kilkenny 1-19, Galway 1-12. It's the 67th Leinster Championship win by the Cats, and the drive for five is on.
We just went out to look after ourselves. We weren't too particularly concerned about the other team, in so much as if we could be as good as we possibly could be ourselves. That's all we could do, really.
Look, there's no recriminations. We were beaten by a better team on the day. There's no complaints in that respect. But we have to heed the lessons from today's Leinster semi-final. We're still in the championship. We have an All-Ireland quarter-final to look forward to at the end of the month. But we're obviously going to have to improve significantly and, regroup. And that's the challenge for the players and management now in the days and weeks ahead.
It was a very blustery breeze out there, and we were kind of conscious of that fact. I think both teams were. But we weren't used to the weather after having this summer, so definitely there's a lot to work on. But we're just delighted to come up to win, and that's what we've done. We're just delighted to go straight through the front door.
I suppose our shooting was wayward. I suppose we definitely didn't take all the chances we created. But that's part and parcel of the process of going through the championship, you know. And we have 5 weeks, I think, roughly speaking, to an Ireland semi-final now, and that's the next challenge. Are you ready for that one?
Well, Dermot, they were pretty awesome again today, weren't they?
Yeah, Kenny, they were definitely impressive. There's you know, I think Brian Cody said it straight out there, you know, they looked after themselves, everything else would take care of it. And I think that was the mentality they went out with today. Do their job, everything else looks after itself.
John McIntyre said they're going to have to learn lessons. Do you think they'll... What lessons do they need to learn based on today?
Yeah, well, I suppose you could argue the same point after a couple of off-league games, you know. If you get chances, you need to start punishing teams at this level. They got a few chances against Kilkenny today. If you don't take them, you won't get a second bite of it.
Yeah. Michael, again, you were really impressed with the teamwork of Kilkenny.
Yeah, look, we've said it all about them over the years, like, just incredible. Going for five All-Irelands, this is their sixth Leinster in a row again, and, you know, lads there with 8, 9, 10 Leinster medals, it's unbelievable. But, you know, just from the very start, what I love about Kilkenny is, when they do the simple things, they line up in orthodox position, there's Owen Larkin with a catch, but they're given, their support play is brilliant, but they're giving the ball to the man the better position all the time. There's no pressure on any of them out there to score themselves. Their job is to give the ball to the guy that's in a better position, and make sure that you take the risk out of any shooting. Here's Michael Rice, who covered nearly every inch of Croke Park today. He just after clearing the ball from the left corner before that, up there to Aidan Fogarty. And you're talking about a team, look at the subs. Aidan Fogarty, Derry Gling, Michael Kavanagh, John Tennyson. You know, Chad Fitzpatrick, who I believe is playing the best hurling, Richie Power, a great scorer. I believe Chad's playing some of the best hurling of his life in Kilkenny and training, and he can't make the team. But little simple passes, it's running off the ball, very brave, you can see here again, good catch. This, I think, probably one of the best scorers of the game. Into Richie Power again. I'd say if they needed a goal, he would have went on there further, tapped it over the bar. But they are an awesome team. Did 17 wides, as Brian Cody said there, 16 or 17 wides, and maybe PJ Ryan had one or two little anxious moments. But outside of that, you know, they look very, very sharp and hungry.
Paul?
Yeah, like, I mean, it's obvious there that the support play that they have, Des, is like other teams we were discussing earlier, other teams would shoot from positions where Kilkenny are drawing the man and leaving off the pass. And you can see there, like, in particularly the first instance, Henry could have taken a shot but gave it to Owen Larkin and a point. They're guaranteeing the scores, and by passing the ball, they're shooting and they're under no pressure when they're shooting, whereas other teams tend to be shooting under pressure, and their hit rate isn't as good as Kilkenny's.
Right, now, on the live game and the coverage today, there was praise from one or two of the panel for Galway tactics. You didn't agree.
Yeah, like Kilkenny.
At half time.
Yeah, Kilkenny obviously played with the wind in the first half. Went for the juggler. Like, Galway obviously had a plan putting Damien Hayes full forward to bring out the half forward line, but JJ Delaney and Tommy Welch picked up a mountain of ball today, uncontested, and had plenty of time then to set up attacks. The Galway clearances were struck under pressure, I suppose, you could argue, but it was just a springboard one after another for Kilkenny to come down the field under no pressure.
Yeah, the way Kilkenny set up, in my opinion, is their six backs playing their positions, their six forwards playing their positions, and they let the two midfielders cover the ground then to, you know, to support them. And you see Michael Rice and Michael Fennelly covering huge area space. But JJ Delaney today and Tommy Walsh looked like there was no one on them, and that was the game plan was for Galway, was to move out the field, try to support their own, to make room for the full forward line inside. But Kilkenny don't buy that, and their forwards work so hard off the ball in closing down the spaces. You know, it made it ineffective
for
Galway.
Michael and like they had the assistance of the strong wind in the second half. Sharp puckouts. They were being beaten in midfield, hands down all day long, and they decided to try drill the ball into the midfield, and they paid the price there with that one. But generally, I think Kilkenny forced you to turn over the ball, but today they didn't have to, because the Galway half forward line just left them free and easy.
And Dermot, it's the quality of ball those men deliver as well, which adds to the pain for Galway.
Yeah, exactly. It's hard enough to keep the ball away from the likes of JJ and Tommy and these fellas, you know, but to give it straight back to them in the instance as Galway did today, you know, it's criminal to win a game of hurling. You can't afford to do that. And they're sharp guys. If they see a man in a better position, they'll give him the ball in a better position, because that's what hurling is about.
I also think so. Sometimes, you look at Tommy Walsh, they're not that particular sometimes where they're hitting it. Their job is to win possession and get it up the field. And the forwards in Kilkenny fight.
The next man win it.
Yeah. Well, they fight for their own ball. There's no whinging out of them about it's not lower, it's not this. Whatever way the ball comes, they go for it and they fight for it. And you know, they're an awesome team and they're just going to take some beating.
But doesn't it come back to everyone is trying to work out a tactic that can beat Kilkenny, and no one has come up with it now for 5 years.
And they won't either, Des, for a while.
Well,
no.
You saw nothing today to say.
No, absolutely not. Even today would reinforce the position that they hold at the moment.
Like Dermot?
Yeah, it's very, very hard. You know, Galway did themselves no favours bringing out, you know, Hayes around the middle of the field. It's criminal. I think if you have to take them on, you have to take them on man-to-man, one-to-one. You know, so be it. If you have to fight for a dirty ball, you fight for it. If you get a good ball, you get a good ball. Yeah. But, you know, it's the dirty ones really that are the key.
Michael, you're seeing Galway hurling now down at Portumna. Can Galway make a big impact after a day like today?
Well, it's going to be tough on them, you know, they have to regroup. They were beaten by 7 points on the scoreboard, but in reality, there was a lot more than that. And, you know, Kilkenny did miss a lot of chances and they really overpowered them in a lot of positions. You know, Joe Cannon, obviously, in Portumna, he'll admit today that not, you know, didn't have a good game, but by any standards, by his huge standards. But I think, you know, I've said it many times, you need to put him into position and leave him there and utilise him. He was played wing corner forward today, wing forward, centre forward, full forward, back out again. Mm-hmm. And it's very hard for any player. He's only 21 years of age at the end of the day. From your confidence has to start taking the baton. And I think they need to settle him, and I'd have him taken the frees as well. Henry Shefflin was out for 9 months with a knee injury. The first day he came back playing for Kilkenny, he was back on the frees. Richie Power never missed a free, I think, while he was away. But you have leaders on your team and main men, and I think they need to build around Joe Cannon.
All right, there's a point emerging I'd like to get all your views on. And should there be cause for concern about the amount of pulling of the face masks on helmets?
Well, it's coming into the game. There's obviously everyone's wearing them now, so I mean, the opportunity is there. You know, in our day, there wasn't face masks really. Yeah.
Let's have a look at there was a couple of incidents from the weekend.
Okay, today, a long ball, Eddie Brennan and Ollie Canning have a tussle. Eddie is booked for a bit of a low pull, but Ollie takes exception to it. They have a bit of a scuffle. Yeah. But the first thing, like, if you grab the helmet, you're in control of the situation, really. That's what players are thinking. But it's very dangerous. You know, you can see even yesterday, you know, a cut a year, but is the yellow card enough? I think this has to be stamped out, because it's going to filter its way down to underage, and it's a serious issue. But a yellow card, in my opinion, isn't enough to stop it.
We saw it yesterday, as Paul said, in the Wexford Tip game, Michael.
Yeah, well, I thought yesterday to start the game it looked terrible. You'll see there, Steve Banville went to shake hands, Fanning walked into him, Banville pulled the stroke on him, and then they start pulling at each other's heads. If you saw 10-year-olds at this, you'd be disgusted with them. But I think, like, for kids looking in, this looks terrible. Like, the helmets are there to be, you have to have respect. Part of hurling over the years, there's things you don't do. You don't pull across the fella's head. That was what we were all taught. Anybody sitting around here, we all pulled the odd stroke, maybe somewhere.
Well, you did anyway, yeah.
Well, maybe somewhere. But, you know, you do things sometimes you're not proud of, and you make mistakes. But something like that, like, it's, to me, it's childish, it's cowardly. And, you know, I think Declan Fanning ended up with a good few stitches yesterday after that incident. And, you know, it needs to be stamped out. I think players in hurling have to have respect. But just on a bigger issue with the helmets,